Hello, and thank you for choosing Flexi 10 as your design and production software. My name is Bobby Fawson, and I'll be your host for today's lesson. This lesson will cover the basic process of creating and outputting a contour cut job. If you have a separate printer and cutter, you will need to make sure both devices, the printer and the cutter, are set up within Production Manager. To start, I have imported the SAi logo in a vector-based format. Creating a contour cut on a raster-based image is a bit more complex and will be covered in a later tutorial, while the basics will remain the same. Now I can select the design or logo and add a contour cut by clicking on the Effects menu and choosing Contour Cut. Within the Design Central window, you can modify the type of contour cut you would like to create. Your options are Contour, Rectangle, and Ellipse. Choosing Contour, the new effect will follow the vector path you have selected. Choosing Rectangle, the contour cut will be just that, a rectangle enclosing your image. Once the effect has been applied by clicking on the checkbox, you can change the size of the effect by typing in the values or resizing using the selection boxes. Choosing Ellipse will surround your image with an ellipse. And the same option is available here to change the size of the ellipse after applying the effect. Keep in mind that no matter which option you choose, you have complete freedom to manipulate the new effect to get the results you want. Starting with Contour, you have the option to change the offset value that will allow you to create an offset cut, a kiss cut, or a bleed cut. If you know the exact value required, simply type it in. Or you can eyeball it and click and drag the offset node here to move the offset distance to your liking. Once you have the offset value set correctly, click on the checkbox within the Design Central window. Your contour cut is now applied to your image. The option box for with holes will allow the contour cut to be applied to an interior line of a compounded object. In this situation, the SAi lettering was grouped and then compounded with the red shape of the logo. Applying a contour cut with holes will tell the cutter to not only cut the outside contour, but also the interior contour or the holes. One more option for the contour cut is the join type seen here. By clicking on this drop-down box, you can choose the join type or what I call the corner type. You can choose from round, miter, or sharp. If you need to edit the contour cut, all you have to do is make the appropriate changes and click the checkbox again. With our contour cut job ready to output, you need to click on the rip and print icon. This will open the rip and print window for you to control the final output. First, you need to confirm you have the blade tab visible. This verifies the effect was applied correctly. Click on this tab to tell the software where you want the print and the cut information to go. As you see here, this job will be sent to my Roland VersaCam VS540 as a hybrid job, meaning it will print, rewind, and cut the job all in one pass. If you need to remove the printed piece from the printer, either to laminate or cut on a separate device, you first need to print the job with registration marks. To do this, choose your cutting device and then change the send option to print only. Now you can choose a registration mark that is specific to the cutter brand you have installed. Now you can hit send to print your job. Once the print is complete with registration marks, you can then remove the material from the printer for lamination or insert into your cutter for immediate cutting. Simply change the send options from print only to contour job only and click send. Your job should now complete. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any comments or suggestions, please visit our website and feel free to submit them using our contact page. Thank you.